Do you need to apply property expenses to the tenant's or the landlord's security deposit? Well, then make sure you watch this video, Applying Security Deposits to Property-Related Expenses. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Any property-related expenses that are necessary to be paid in order to keep the landlord in compliance with their lease agreements and property regulations are paid by us, the management company, up front. We could withhold the expense from the landlord's next payout and show it on the statement the way we learned in previous videos, or we could deduct this payment from one of the two types of security deposits. For example, on March 4th, we paid Staples $350 for supplies as a result of Candy Charles, who is a tenant under the landlord, Alan Arby. Only Candy, not Alan, is responsible for these supplies. Therefore, they will be deducted from her security deposit balance. So what are the steps to apply the security deposit to expenses? Well, there's the first part, which we're about to do, and it's very simple. We record the payment of the property expense in the write checks window. We make sure that we select the specific tenant that the expense is applied to, and you must make sure that you check it as billable to that tenant or that landlord. And then you must type the reason in the memo field. So what will happen after step one? Well, supplies expense will go up because QuickBooks thinks that it's our supplies expense, and cash in bank obviously will go down because we just paid property-related expenses. QuickBooks doesn't know yet that the landlord or the tenant will be responsible for that check after we do step two. So what will happen in the trial balance after step one? Well, we have less cash in bank, so cash in bank will decrease to $6,450 for the amount that we physically paid, and the computer thinks that we have the supplies expense, so supplies expense will increase to $350. We open the checks window and we make sure that the date is fast forwarded to March 4th of 2022. The company whom we're paying is Staples, and we're paying them $350. Notice QuickBooks remembers that Staples goes with supplies expense, and in this case, we agree. The most important part is to choose the specific landlord or tenant that the money is responsible for, and notice it's checked off as billable by default. We're almost ready to save this check, but remember, we have to put a memo if we're going to put it on an invoice later, so the explanation will flow through to the final invoice and to the deposit report. So we must type in the memo field whatever the explanation might be in your real situation. But don't forget to type in this memo field as your last step so that ultimately you can see the reason printed clearly on the security deposit report. So we click save and close, and the result in the trial balance is exactly as what we expected. Cash in bank went down to $6,450, and supplies expense, our supplies expense is temporarily showing at $350. Now that we've written the check, we must do the same second step that we learned about in prior videos when we previously learned how to apply property-related expenses to the landlord's payout balance. Now we're doing step two in the same way, but we're applying it to the tenant's deposit. So we must immediately make an invoice for that landlord's or that tenant's expense. We must add the check payment that we just recorded to that invoice. And then we must copy the description field into the memo field to make sure that the information flows through to the final report. And then, of course, we save the invoice. Now, what will happen in the trial balance after part two? Well, our supplies expense will go down because part two indicates that we are no longer responsible for these supplies because we're billing our tenant for it. And of course, the management company no longer has supplies expense, but of course, the security deposit of the tenant will decrease because now the tenant is responsible and will therefore receive less of their security deposit returned on the day that they move out. So what happens in the trial balance after we make this invoice? Well, our supplies expense will disappear because the computer now knows that we are not responsible for that, and the tenant's security deposit, which is right here, will decrease by the amount of the expense because we now owe less to the tenants in future payouts of paying back the security deposit because we just applied some to the expenses that they're responsible for. So this is how we make the final step. We click invoice. Now notice, as soon as we choose the specific tenant that is responsible for this expense, we get this message. And don't worry, you can click OK and choose the expense that you just put. And if you lost the box, don't worry. You could get it to come back by making sure that you have the ribbon open. And in the main section of the ribbon, click Add Time and Cost to get the billable cost box to return. So we click expense and we choose the specific expense that we are putting on this invoice and we click OK. Notice the information flowed through from the check, but to make sure that it flows through to the report, we copy it like we learned in a previous video and we put it in the memo field so that the deposit report shows clearly what this was. Lastly, the most important thing you need to know about this invoice. This invoice is not being applied to a landlord's rent payout. And this invoice is not being applied to the landlord's deposit. This invoice is being applied to the tenant's security deposit. So you have to make sure if you're making an invoice for the security deposit or for an expense that will, you know, be applied to the security deposit, you must choose this account. Now when you click save and close, and you don't forget to remove the stupid email thing, save and close, now the results in the trial balance are exactly as what we expected. We no longer have supplies expense because we have to pay $350 less to the tenants when we pay back the security deposit, and that's why their balance is $3,650. The most important part to look at is not the trial balance. The most important part to look at after step two is this report, tenant security deposit. If you look at Candy, you see that on March 1, she gave a $1,000 security deposit. But you see on March 4th, we have this invoice that lowered the amount that we're going to pay back by $350, and that's why she's only getting back $650 on the day she moves out. Notice that it doesn't have the column for memo, so let's take care of that right now. Customize, display. Let's make sure that just like the rent report, we have a memo here, and notice the memo field tells us the reason why. So if we set up this security deposit report to include the memo field, we can see she paid us the $1,000 on March 1. We can double click and we can go right back to that payment, and we can even look at the copy of the check if we want to. But then we can open up this invoice that says we lowered the security deposit for this reason. Candy cost us these supplies. And we can double click and go right back to the invoice, and we can even take a look at the attachment if we want to see the receipt of the invoice if you scanned it in. And this clearly explains to Candy why she is only receiving $650. Now in our second example, we will show how to apply a landlord's deposit to a property related expense. Let's imagine on March 16, we paid $700 to Paula the plumber to fix the sink in Freddie Froda's apartment, and Freddie is a tenant under Dave Deeney. Now let's imagine that in this case, Dave the landlord is responsible for this repair and not the tenant. Therefore, it will be deducted from his security deposit balance. So what will happen after the first step when we record paying this property expense? Well, repair expense goes up and cash goes down. Repair expense goes up because QuickBooks doesn't know yet that the landlord or the tenant will be responsible. It thinks we will be responsible, and that's why it will record our company's repair expense. And then of course cash and bank will go down because we physically paid the money. So what happens in the trial balance after step one? Well, our repair expense will show up in the trial balance for $700 temporarily after the first step. And of course, because we have $700 less in cash, the balance of the bank account goes down to $5,750. Let's go ahead and record the check. It's a check, and it's a check on March 16, and it's a check to Paula the plumber. Remember, if she's not on the vendor list, you can click Add New, Vendor, and just type in her name. And spelling doesn't count. Most importantly, we paid her $700, and the reason was because of repair expense, and this is not billable to the specific tenant. Remember, the landlord is responsible, and it will come out of the landlord's deposit, not the tenant, and by default it's marked as billable. Don't forget to put a memo so that the reason for this check can flow through to the invoice, and the reason for this check can flow through to the final report. And you put you put whatever you want, and then you click save and close. Now the results in the trial balance are exactly as what we expected. Repair expense showed up for $700, and cash and bank decreased by the amount we paid to $5,750. And now we'll do part two. Bill the landlord, deposit for the expense that we just paid. So what will happen when we actually make the deposit of the landlord responsible for the property expense? Well, our repair expense will go down because the management company no longer has repair expense. The client is responsible, and therefore their operating deposit will decrease because now we have to pay them back less of a security deposit because of that property expense. So what will be the numbers in the trial balance after step two? Well, we will no longer have repair expense because the client is responsible. And because it's coming out of the landlord's operating deposit, we now owe $700 less to the landlords for their operating deposit when we go to pay them back in the future, and it decreases to $3,300. And we make it the way we learned before. We open the invoice, and on the exact same day, we bill the landlord, not the tenant, the landlord, because in this example, the landlord is responsible. Now, we click OK to get the expense, choose it just like we've been doing all along, and you see it comes up here. And the most important thing is to copy the information into the memo field so that it flows through to the final report. And speaking of the final report, the most important thing to check, we save for last. This is not coming out of the tenant security deposit. It's not coming out of the normal rent payout. This is coming out of the landlord's operating deposit. So we make sure that that is the account that's chosen so that everything works perfectly. Save and close. You got to remember to save and close. And now you can see the results in the trial balance are exactly as what we expected. We no longer show repair expense because our landlord client is responsible, and you can see their operating deposit has decreased by the amount of expense we applied. But the most important report is this one, the details of the operating deposit for the landlord. If we click here and we look at Dave, we can say, look, Dave, on March 1, you did give us $2,000, but you see, on the other hand, on the 16th, we had to pay $700. And when you double click, you can see that you replaced the old sink, and that's the reason why. In fact, we actually forgot to put the memo field on this report so that you can see this information clearly showing on the report when we print it for Dave. So you can click Customize Report and add the memo field. And now that you've added the memo field, it's clear what the reason was for the decrease in the deposit balance for Dave. And if you want to print this and give this just to Dave, you can further customize the report and filter, press the letter N for name, and choose only just Dave and click OK. And now you can see this report shows only Dave why he's only getting $1,300 back if he quits and leaves us tomorrow.